afternoon, 47. Your destination is the annual Global Innovation Motor Race in Miami, Florida. After analyzing the data from Reynard's computer, the case is clear. The Providence defectors are Robert and Sierra Knox, head of robotics developer Kronstadt Industries. A visionary inventor and technological innovator, Robert Knox has spearheaded Kronstadt Industries to the bleeding edge of technological development. His equally brilliant daughter, Sierra, is not only a financial wizard, but also a fiercely competitive race car driver with a fiery temper to match. Kronstadt enjoys enormous popularity with global consumers. However, few are aware that the company is also one of the world's leading suppliers of next-gen military tech. Last year, despotic ruler Jin Po employed prototype Kronstadt drones against peaceful civilian protesters in the now infamous Tungyan Valley incident. And although it has yet to be proven, there is little doubt that the Knoxes personally brokered the deal, making them complicit in a war crime. It is unclear why the Knoxes would betray their masters, but likely, the fear of being next on the Shadow Client's hit list has pressured them to cut a deal with the enemy. Undoubtedly, with Kronstadt Industries on their side, the militia will increase their attacks tenfold. And so our contract obligates us to retire Robert and Sierra Knox and contain the damage they may inflict on Providence. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Miami, 47. The innovation race is on its last day, and it is down to the wire. Thousands of eager fans are gathered for the final laps of this unexpectedly close race. Sierra Knox is expertly piloting her red Kronstadt car. Her father, Robert Knox, roams the nearby expo building where Kronstadt is showcasing its new prototype car. The Kronstadt RK Mark III has seen fierce competition from the Chinese Kowloon Heavy Industries' new racer. Moses Lee, CEO of Kowloon, has taken a dominant lead and looks invincible. Sierra Knox will need to risk it all if she wants to win for the third year in a row. The stakes are as high as they can get. Thank you. that is Ted Mendez, one of the country's most influential military-grade money men. This must be connected to Kronstadt.
Huh? Bingo. Looking good, man. Looking good.
What do you do?
Mr. Mendez, good to see you, sir. The demonstration is scheduled to... He's on his way upstairs now.
Excuse me. Can you tell me where to go, please?
It's just up these stairs.
Hey, how you doing?
Mr. Mendez?
to say something provocative now, Ted. War is going out of fashion. It's dirty. It's just plain bad PR. Nobody wants to exchange their children and loved ones for flags and medals anymore. The glory is gone, Ted. But luckily, Kronstadt has a solution for that. Imagine this. Android infiltrators operating in the field, disguised and fully embedded, ready to strike at a moment's notice. Indestructible robotic operators who can infiltrate the deepest sanctuary of any adversary, striking an unseen fatal blow, a surgical tool for a blunt world. Imagine an army of them, fully equipped android medics, seeking out wounded servicemen and injured civilians, bringing them to safety, or patching them up then and there. Android pilots delivering payloads deep inside enemy territory with uncanny precision and minimal collateral damage. All right, Mendez, it's very straightforward. Let me show you. I just pick any of the pictures on the desk, then I use the scanner to upload the biometric data, and Palace will do the rest.
Target acquired. WB.
Obviously, the final system won't rely on you manually feeding it biometric data. This is still a prototype. This is a pivotal moment in modern conflict solution, Ted. Palace is entirely foolproof. All you need is to pick a photo from the table and scan it just like I showed you. It's perfectly safe. Go ahead. Make my day.
Greetings, sir.
Happen when Knox and the engineers integrate into
collecting pictures of celebrity entrepreneurs now, 47? What are you thinking?
Hey, Rob.
Wow.
I'm ready for another demonstration, Mr. Knox.
Great, Ted. Great. I knew you were just playing hard to get. Let's do it. Get out of my face. I mean it. Ted. Don't you know who I am? You're invading my private space here. Don't you know who I am? Ted. Let me give you the rundown again.
Jesus. Robert Knox.
Aw, cripes.
What the hell? Robert Knox down. Now for the heir to the Kronstadt Empire.
Okay, stay calm.
Come on, we need some help here to clean this mess up.
scuffle, but the real mascot is still over there. If I don't get them, I've got no evidence. Bye-bye money. I don't know. I need to figure something out. I'll talk soon.
A disgruntled...
Hey, yo, did you find some keys over there? Oh man, you're a real lifesaver, thank you.
The race is entering its final lap, 47.
Sorry.
47, the race is over. Sierra will be coming off the track any time now.
Nice outfit. Really brings out your eyes. Ms. Knox informed me you'd be here. She asked to make sure you brought the documents. So, did you bring the documents?
I have the papers right here.
Excellent. Come on in. Have a seat or something. I'll let Ms. Knox know you're here.
So far, so good, 47. Now, let's see where this meeting is headed.
If you see anything weird, report to us immediately.
Thank you.
Wow.
So, Mr. I never did catch your name.
Names are for friends.
Very well. Straight to the point in all business. Walk with me.
Where are we going?
Don't worry. What am I gonna do? Kill you in broad daylight. I just want a bit of privacy here. Not about to do sensitive business like this in front of an audience.
Good idea.
So just to get this straight.
You claimed in your email to have somehow found internal reports that show Kronstadt's involvement in the Tungan Valley Massacre.
Sounds about right.
Let's be clear. You and I are having this meeting because my father doesn't need to know about this. It's just another undesired distraction. I don't care if the information is true or false. I don't care if it mentions moving money from the Nexus Project into Tungan Valley Damage Control, as you claimed in your correspondence. I do care about protecting my father, which is why you and I are now here.
I see.
Leave me alone for a few minutes, guys.
Sure thing, Miss Knox. If you need us, just call. We're right around the corner.
So here's the deal. You hand over the documents and leave, and that's the end of it. And you will do that now. Well, what are you waiting for? Hand me the documents. All talk and no play makes Sierra a dull girl. We're done here.
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.